Great Britain. The world-famous press agency, Reuters, whose news reports serve 1 billion people every day, carried a story containing extracts from an interview with Adnan Oktar by Tom Hennigan, the agency's senior religious correspondent based in its Paris office. Titled, "Muslim Creationist Preaches Islam and Awaits Christ," the report said, Harun Yahya is one of the most widely distributed authors in the Muslim world. His glossy books and DVDs on religion and science sell in Islamic bookshops around the globe. He lets readers download much of his work from his websites for free. In its May-June 2008 issue, the magazine New Humanist, which has been published in London ever since 1885, carried an article about the rise of creationism in Europe. The story, by a Danish evolutionist professor, noted the impact Adnan Oktar's work was having in Europe. Before the book arrived, many had no idea there was a resurgent Muslim creationism in Europe. One thing is clear. Creationism has indeed come to Europe. Therefore, we have to take it seriously. What we have seen so far is just the beginning. The British Morning Star, publishing organ of the Communist Party, announced its unease at the rise of creationist belief with the headlines, "Rise of the Evolution Deniers," and "Ken MacLeod Investigates the Disturbing Rise of Evolution Denial in British Society." The collapse in Europe of Darwinism, the supposed scientific basis for communism, is alarming the proponents of communist ideology because there can be no communism where there is no Darwinism. With the realization of the false nature of Darwinism, communism has today lost the support it used to draw from Darwinism and is condemned to be remembered as a discredited ideology. This is what the article had to say about the rise in the belief in creation. 35 years ago, I mentioned creationism to one of my zoology tutors at Glasgow University. "Nobody," he said, "takes these people seriously." Today, another of my former tutors, Roger Downey, who is now professor of zoological education at Glasgow University, has to take creationism, or evolution denial as he prefers to call it, a bit more seriously than that. In Islam, creationism is more mainstream than it is in Christianity. The most prominent Muslim creationist, the Turkish writer Harun Yahya's, books and CDs are finally produced.